Good morning, Steve Whiteside here with this week's edition of Fertilizer Stock Trends for Friday, October 8th, 2010. Now, the Fertilizer Stock Index has been on a sell signal for a week now, and it saw some strength this week. In fact, on Wednesday, it traded above the channel line, the upper channel line, but is currently trading within the channel and closed in the middle of it yesterday. We need to close above 45.10 to give us a buy signal for the index. We have seen some stocks come back. Obviously, any new buy signals here are not low-risk buying opportunities. So we are looking for a more significant pullback to give us low-risk buying opportunities. The pros and the public are basically intertwined right now. No guidance here. It's a basically a neutral reading. The selling that we saw last week was not enough to affect longer-term investors. This is the daily midterm chart. We really need to go down and break down below last week's low and close below 42.25. That would give us a sell signal on this particular chart, which would tell us that longer-term investors are more stressed about fertilizer stocks. Looking at the daily flypaper channel, you can see that we've got a nice little uptrend line there. If we take out last week's low, that would take us down to the channel. The lower edge of the channel is down at 40, so that would be about a 10% drop for this index from where we are right now. Looking at the individual stocks in this index, starting with Agrium on the Canadian exchange, we're looking for a close above 78.56 to give us a buy signal. Got pretty close to that over the last couple of days. In the U.S., we're looking for a close above 76.90 for Agrium. For American Vanguard, we're looking for a close above 671. For Bungie, we're looking for a close above 59.58. For CF Industries, we're looking for a close above 99.65. And again, this stock's gotten pretty close to getting buy signals the last 2 days. For Converted Organics, we're looking for a close above 44 cents. For Hanfeng on the TSX, we're looking for a close above 641. For Intrepid Potash, we're now on a buy signal as of Thursday's close. We need to close below 25.89 to change that. Looking at LSB, we need to close below 18.43 to give us a sell signal. For Mageo on the TSX, we're looking for a close above 6.73. For Monsanto, we're looking for a close above 51.06 to give us a buy signal on Friday. For Mosaic, we're looking for a close above 61.73. For Potash, we're looking for a close above 146.42. For Potash on the TSX, we're looking for a close above 148.91. For Potash 1, we're looking for a close below 381. Syngenta's been on a buy signal for a couple of days now. We need a close below 50.27 to give us a new sell signal. Terra's also on its second day of a buy signal. We need a close below 94.86. For Scott's, we're looking for a close below 50.98. And for Western Potash, we're looking for a close below 65 cents. Okay, that's all for this week's edition of Fertilizer Stock Trends. Obviously, not a lot has happened last week. We saw some selling last week. We've come back into the channel. Being in the channel is neutral. We have seen some new buy signals. If you don't want to take the buy signals, you certainly have to cover any short positions. But I could understand if you didn't want to take the new buy signals, given that they aren't really low risk buying opportunities, and I would want to see a much bigger sell-off, at least down to the flypaper channel, before I initiate any new positions in fertilizer stocks. Okay, that's all for this week, folks. It's a holiday here in Canada. It's Thanksgiving, and so I'll be back. Next time you'll hear from me is on Tuesday morning. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.